This video will be an application which makes facial expressions from a single image of a person. I am using Pinocchio to download the application in the Discover section. You can search for Facepoke. This is the application. Click download to get the application. For some reason I had to try 3 times for installation. After download, you can open the application from the home section. This is the interface. I prefer using the application on the internet browser by clicking this pop-out option. This in the center is the option to upload the subject image. The application is not heavy on the hardware. I am using a 3rd generation, 10-year-old computer, and a 4060 graphic card. For this test, I am using an image generated by Focus from our previous videos. There aren't many options in the interface. The subject has some selectable elements. To make the selectable visible, we have to check this box. The selectable can be modified to give the subject an expression. If I left click and drag up, then release the click, there is a slight delay. This could be due to an older computer. I will go again, take the highlighted area by left click and drag down to its original position. You can select all the elements and manipulate by dragging and releasing it to have it adjusted by AI. You have to play around for a few minutes to understand. Dragging it up opens the eye, and going down closes the eye. Same goes with the mouth. The best part is I do not have to wait for an image to be generated. It gets changed in real time. This is to select the face and move it into a different direction. My pointer is in the center. If I go right and click, it will turn the face slightly to the left. But if I hold the center by clicking and dragging to the left, it will pull the head in the left direction. I suggest positioning the head first as needed. After that, work on the other part of the face. Again, from the center, if I go slightly up and click, it will turn the head in the same direction. It can be done in other different directions as well. Changing head directions does break the expressions. You may have to work on expression again. Try doing it slowly, or you will end up having something like this. Fix can be done by a click in the center. You can add a smile by selecting and dragging to the right, clicking in different areas to point the face in the same direction. Fix it by a click in the center. If we compare with the original image, sharp details are lost. But we can have the details by using some upscaler. The face generated with expression had made this area thicker. I may be wrong. What do you think? If I lift her head up slightly, it is thicker than it should be. If we search Facepoke on the internet, there is a different version to try. I think it works the same way, but with these buttons, instead of the dragging option we saw on the personal computer. There are a few extra options here, but I was not able to try because it is occupied by multiple users currently. You can click, duplicate this space, but you have to pay a few dollars. The project is great. I tried using different images. While trying, I used an image where the subject was at a distance. You will see the hair did not move when the face got changed. If you look properly, the application works in a specific area of the image, having a face. In this image, a rectangular area. Let me know if you find this interesting. What video would you like next?